Focus on the first casualty that was reported in Karnataka's Kalburgi. He was in Saudi Arabia in February and on his return was tested positive for coronavirus.
Now, the 43 persons who had come in close contact with this person have been isolated and they have been kept under home isolation and they are being watched very closely. Kalburgi, we are taking steps to put up one isolation ward, 200-bedded isolation ward.
Can you give us an update on who this patient was?
Well, Apurva, absolutely. In fact, you know, we're understanding now that this man, hailed from Kalburgi. He was a 76-year-old senior citizen. And we're also now understanding that, you know, he suffered from hypertension and asthma, amongst other things, amongst other ailments. And apart from that, he also had a travel history of, going to Saudi Arabia between, in fact, the end of Jan and the end of February. And possibly now, of course, they are going to be doing a case history to, actually see if he contracted the coronavirus from there and whether, of course, that was the reason that he actually passed away. But yes, amongst other things, this is the first case of coronavirus positive that has been tested in India, the first casualty.
All right. Also, Neha, if you can also give us a brief timeline on this entire incident that has come to light, the fact that this is the first casualty that has now been reported, his travel history, what happened when he was brought back, what happened when he was tested positive. Can you give us a brief timeline on that?
Absolutely, Apurva. Let's actually begin from January to February, and that's when he's actually travelled to Saudi Arabia. He's returned from Saudi Arabia. He's landed at the Hyderabad airport, February 29th is what we're understanding. And after that, on March 6th is when he, even after being screened at the airport, he did not really show any symptoms. Now, almost about, a week later, he started showing symptoms of, fever, cough, cold and others at a private hospital. In fact, in Kalburgi itself. Now, even after that, on March 6th, on March 9th, owing to the fact that his symptoms, started to aggravate, his cough, cold and fever also increased, on March 9th, he was, in fact, diagnosed as a case of pneumonia and his samples were then sent for, a test of the coronavirus. Now, this was on March 9th, almost about, a week after his return from Saudi Arabia. Now, after that, without actually waiting for the test report, the doctors have in fact insisted that he be discharged, that he be taken to a bigger hospital, and that is when they actually decided to keep him, instead of keeping him in the isolation ward, they've actually moved him further to this hospital in Hyderabad. Later he was transferred and also he was admitted, and then once he was discharged from the hospital in Hyderabad, it was on March 10th on his way back to Kalburgi from Hyderabad that he passed away, even before the report had come positive. So, yes, he had given it for testing at the time, and on his return to his hometown, Kalburgi, he passed away. It is, rather unfortunate. And now that, this has come to light, we're seeing how the entire state of Karnataka is on alert and measures are being taken. But the health department has requested people not to panic, not to fear, and to maintain basic personal hygiene, keep washing hands every 2 hours. These are measures that we have also been reiterating on Mirror Now.
Absolutely.
You.
And also, Neha, right now it will be important to understand what are the other measures that has been taken. What about his family? Have they been quarantined as well? Because this is the first death that have been reported. So what is the kind of procedures that have been followed from here on in terms of the other family members or other people that he has been in contact with?
Yes, Apurva, so two things here. First of all the people whom he came in contact with during, his stay in Saudi Arabia, during his travel back to Hyderabad at the Hyderabad airport, and from Hyderabad to Kalburgi during his travel as well, all of those people are now going to be tracked. It is a mammoth task for the Karnataka Health Department. Those people are going to be traced, they are going to be isolated, they are going to be made to undergo tests. That's one. Secondly, also, his immediate family whom he was residing with, all of them will also have to undergo the coronavirus test. They will also be isolated. And third and most importantly, as far as, this man's burial or cremation is concerned, all the protocols would be followed as per the Union Health Ministry. And, we'll really have to actually wait and see. In our conversation with the Health Department of Karnataka yesterday, they said that all standard protocol is being followed.
All right, Neha, many thanks for joining us and bringing us all those updates. 76-year-old man from Kalburgi is the first casualty of coronavirus in India.